Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our mains answer writing series, in which what we do, we daily give you a question of which you have to write the answer. So friends, continuance of this series, we have also started a series which will discuss the model answer of that question which is given to you daily. So let's see what is the question of today. So the question was, what is zero budget natural farming? Examine its need in the light of agricultural scenario in India. So here we have to define what is zero budget natural farming, and we have to examine it in the light of the present agricultural scenario that is prevailing in India. So the word limit is 250 and the maximum marks are 15. So friends, before proceeding, let me tell you that this is not a model answer, because no answer in UPSC can be model answer. Had that been the case, the UPSC toppers would have scored 100% marks. But their marks range between 50 to 55%. So it is simple that there is no such thing as model answer. We say it for the sake of your convenience, because students have the habit to say to call a particular answer as model answer, but no such thing is exists in reality. So take it only as a reference source. So let's start our discussion. So what is zero budget natural farming? So as is clear from its name, friends, it is a method of farming which doesn't require the external inputs. So it reduces the cost of growing and harvesting. In fact, it makes the cost of growing and harvesting plants to zero, because external inputs like chemical fertilizers and your pesticides are not needed, and also water is not needed in that to that extent. So there is a reduction, or we can say there is a zero input cost. So that is called zero budget natural farming. So farmers need not purchase fertilizers and pesticides to ensure the healthy growth of crops. So basically it is a type of farming which uses biological pesticides and fertilizers instead of chemical based fertilizers. So farmers use earthworms, cow dung, urine, plants, human excreta, and some other such other biological fertilizers for crop protection and crop production. So it reduces farmers' investment and also protects the soil from degrading. So it protects the soil from degradation. So basically it is a method. Again, the point has been emphasized that the method is which promotes chemical-free agriculture, drawing from traditional Indian practices. So it was originally promoted by Maharashtrian agriculturist and Padma Shri recipient, that is Subhash Palekar, so who developed it in 1990s as an alternative to Green Revolution's method driven by chemical fertilizers, pesticides and intensive irrigation. So recently the finance minister in her recent budget speech said that zero budget farming is already being practiced in various states, for example Himachal Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh. So she has emphasized that zero budget farming can be a potential area which can help in doubling the farmer incomes in the days to come. So you might be knowing that Government of India has the target of doubling farmers' income by 2022. So this zero budget natural farming has been identified one of the way to do so. So there are several states, as I have earlier told you, Andhra Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh are there, which are aggressively showing drift to this model. What are the main wheels, or we can say main pillars of zero budget natural farming? Broadly, these are water vapor condensation for better soil moisture. The promotion is not of the using intensive irrigation, but rather to use the moisture so that this water vapor condensation can take place and the soil can be better moistured. And focus is also on seed treatment by natural means, that is cow dung and urine based formulations. So microbial fermentations are prepared and they are used to treat seeds, as well as mulching and soil aeration for favorable soil conditions, and ensure soil fertility through cow dung and cow urine based concoctions. So basically it is nothing but use of fermented microbial organisms. Now features, what are the important features? So as I've told you, important features are that the application of Jivamruta is there, that is a fermented microbial culture. It could be Jivamruta could be referred to a mixture of fresh desi cow dung and aged desi cow urine, jaggery, pulse, flour, water and soil. So you can see that everything that is being used, it is natural. So this fermented microbial culture is applied to the soil. In fact, it supplies nutrients to the soil and acts as a catalytic agent to promote activity of microorganisms and earthworm in the soil. So similar mixture is called this Bijamrita, which is used to treat sites, seeds, while concoctions using neem leaves and pulp, tobacco and green chilies are prepared for insect and pest management. So you need not remember these things. You can refer that cow dung, or for that matter cow urine and water, and then human excreta are used as chemicals as well as fertilizers, fertilizers as well as pesticides. So what is the, now the main question is, what is the need and significance of this natural budget farming in Indian agricultural scenario? So friends, if we go in the depth of this need and significance, we can count n number of factors, but here we have included some important factors only. First and the foremost objective is that we are seeing that there is a rising, the costs of inputs are rising, but the return of the farmers are falling because of the lack of the productivity, because of the soil degradation. So which in turn pushes them to apply more and more chemical fertilizer and pesticides and irrigation, and in turn it increases the input cost of the farmer, and he or she is not remunerated in a fair manner. So basically this has led to the indebtedness of the farmers and has become the leading cause of suicide. And then National Sample Survey Office data shows that 70% of the agricultural households spend more than they earn, and almost more than half of the farmers they are in debt. So basically states such as Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, they have level of indebtedness around 90%, where each household bear an average debt of 1 lakh. So without the need to spend money on these inputs or take loans to buy them, the cost of production in case of zero budget natural farming is basically zero. So this helps in breaking the debt cycle. The farmers, specifically the small farmers, that are facing this debt cycle. So meanwhile, then intercropping allows for increased returns, and then also it aims to ensure that farming, particularly smallholder farming, becomes viable. Because smallholder farming is quite prevalent in India due to the marginal land holding quite large, and this doesn't promote economies of scale. So this in turn has given a push to the input cost, but the income is not that much. So small farming is becoming unviable. So the people are leaving farming because of its unsustainability. So it can be made viable. So obviously people can be kept in it by innovative way. And the consequent pressure on the urbanization can also be tackled if there is not forced migration. So also then it reduces farmers' costs, eliminating external inputs and in situ resources to rejuvenate soils. So in turn it increases incomes, obviously, because productivity increases because of the soil rejuvenation, because of the natural techniques, and then ecosystem is restored and biodiversity is restored. So there is a kind of cascading effect. So ecosystem health is restored through diverse multi-layered cropping system. So also it promotes soil aeration, minimal watering, intercropping, bunds and topsoil mulching, and discourages intensive irrigation and deep lowing. So if there is soil aeration and if there is minimal watering, then obviously there will be minimal loss of the resources, and also it discourages deep lowing and in turn keeps the structure of the soil intact, intact and compact. So this ensures that soil erosion doesn't take place, thus the problem of siltation doesn't take place. And also the impact of chemicals is there on environment and on long-term fertility of the soil. So these local inputs, what they do, they avoid these chemicals and they do they are a miraculous care to revive the fertility and nutrient value of soil. So it is estimated that 1 gram of cow dung is believed to have anywhere between 300 and 500 beneficial microorganisms. So obviously these microorganisms, they decompose the dry organic matter that is there on the soil, that is dried biomass, and it convert into ready to use nutrients for plants. So it requires only 10% of water and 10% electricity. So obviously cost will be reduced, resilience of the agriculture will increase. So also as we are seeing in India, the water crisis, as is highlighted by Niti Aayog report on composite water management index and pointed out by different independent searches, this zero budget natural farming can also be helpful in tackling that water crisis, because agriculture is the largest consumer of water in India. So that this ensures that there is prudent use of resources, and then it may improve the potential of crops to adapt to and be produced for evolving climatic conditions. And then resilient food systems are being produced already in drought prone areas. This has started, that is, resilient food systems have reportedly seen promising changes. So then there is also it has been found that post green revolution the crops that were used, they required intensive irrigation, but this organic farming can reduce that dependence upon water and can make the crops resilient and can in turn meet the emerging changes of the climate change, and also water crisis can be solved. So also then use of natural techniques eliminate the possible causes of air pollution. For example, fertilizers have nitrogen in them. So when fertilizers are applied to the soil, that the formation of nitrous oxide takes place, that is a gas that causes acid rain. So the such type of gases can the emission of such type of gases can be reduced, and also agricultural runoff and consequent water pollution is also reduced, because there is no chemical fertilizer, and if in case runoff happens, first of all runoff doesn't happen due to the better kind of, we can say, aeration of the soil and better moisture in the soil, and if in case to take place, that is the nutrients in water are not that much that it will affect the water body, in which ultimately the entire water channel drains. So food chain also becomes healthy, friends, due to non-use of chemical fertilizers and pesticides. So now the question arises, is it effective? So there are different researches, independent researches, which have claimed that yes, it benefits, and others have said no, it doesn't create any benefit. So a limited study in 2017 in Andhra Pradesh found that there is a sharp decline in the cost of inputs. But then there are also other researches reports which suggest that farmers who had shifted to zero budget natural farming, later they again reverted to that chemical farming because of their declining returns from zero budget natural farming. And also the critics of this farming say that that green revolution was responsible for the transformation of India from a food dependent country to food self-sufficient country. So it has ensured the food security for India, so which was not there prior to green revolution. And then they warn against a wholesale move away from that model without sufficient proof, and that yields not be affected. So Sikkim is often cited as the example of a tale that is used as a cautionary tale, because it had converted to organic farming, but due to the declining yields, there is a shift back to chemical farming. So government initiatives are also there to promote and support this zero budget natural farming. For example, Parampara Gat Krishi Vikas Yojana and your Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana, which both support the zero budget natural farming. And then conclusion, what should be the now conclusion? Conclusion is simple, friends, we can't just shift we can say without thinking about the possible negative outcomes that can be there. So obviously if we want to shift, there must be a proper study, and there must be pilot basis studies and pilot basis introduction of such a technique. And then if in case it is found kind of yielding to results, then we can shift towards this farming based upon scientifically verifiable we can say model. So this is all about. So in case it is found successful, then we can enable an institutional mechanism that can be put in place to promote the technology. So friends, this is all about today's discussion. If you like the question, if you like the video, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly friends, if in case you want to join the daily mains answer writing initiative of us, then you can join using this link. The link is shown here. So this link will also be provided in the description box. So what are the benefits of joining? So daily one question for answer writing will be given to you, and on every Sunday we will take your full length test of the target topic given for the week. So comprehensive evaluation of your answers will also be done, and valuable feedback will be given to you, and reference sources relating to each question will be shared with you, which you call model answer but not in our terminology. And also friends, it is least costly because you can join on monthly basis as well in just ₹1999. That is, you will be getting the one question daily on weekdays, and on Sunday we will be taking your full length test. So in case you are interested to join, then do ensure that you check the link in the description box that is shown on your screen. And also friends, if in case you find it costly, then we have another initiative for daily mains answer writing, which costs you just ₹499. So in which what you have to do, you have to just subscribe for the initiative, and you will be getting daily questions for answer writing practice, and we will evaluate your answers, and we'll share with you model answers. But we will not be in this case, you will not be getting the full length test on Sunday. So that's why the reduction in cost is there. So one service that will not be available, that is on Sunday in this case. So if in case you are interested to join any of them, you can check the description box where the links are given. And lastly, if you have any doubts, if you have any queries, then you are most welcome. You can mail us at achieveias21@gmail.com. You can also contact us 8968920720. So friends, this is all about today's video. Thank you. Have a very nice day ahead.